On the surface of things, it might have looked like the market didn't have any sort of particularly exciting day. You know, we had some floating around, up and down, right on the trend line, the flat line for the S&P 500. But if you look under the hood, you'll see some other things in the mechanics. We had more advancing than declining stocks, and the S&P equal weight outperformed the S&P market cap weighted index. So this tells us that the heavier companies that are taking up a large of the S&P 500 and consequently have also taken up a lot of the recent S&P 500 gains weren't necessarily performing as well as the average or below average market cap company. And this is something I have been focusing on and I encourage you to focus on: price, valuation. Where are you getting the best deal and the most bang for your buck? Because that's an important part of choosing to buy the right stock, is the price. So today we saw well-priced stocks, broadly speaking, generally speaking, outperform more expensive stocks that have seen massive gains and are occupying a large percentage of the S&P 500. And that's a healthy thing. It's showing true market diversity and appetite for something that's not necessarily Apple or Microsoft, and encouragement to look for good deals, because the good deals now seem to be performing well. And I expect that to continue. I certainly think the market is on a upward trend, and this isn't a trend that I expect to end at any point. It's possible that we do receive, unfortunately, some sort of pullback, but I'm not planning for that. I'm not, doing anything crazy. If we see some sort of massive run over the next several days, yes, I will buy some S&P 500 put options, some SPY put options. I will do that, but I will do that as a speculative bet. It's almost like buying a small pharmaceutical company. I don't know if it's going to pan out, but I know it's a pretty good calculated risk reward because the market has risen, the options are cheap relatively, and a pullback is possible. But if that happens, I will look to be selling those options quickly. I'm just telling you how I'm planning in case that state of mind happens to interest you. I'm not at that point yet. I still want the market to continue chugging higher a little bit here. And once it's gotten too hot, several days of green, big greens over 1%, maybe I'll consider doing that. It's nothing more than a trade though. And that is what I think is providing a lot in this market. We had incredible inflows, I believe it was last week, of $58 billion, record amount. People are feeling very speculative, and I think it leads to some weak hands, some paper hands, as people are saying now, entering the market. And this $58 billion, so a bunch of it comes in, all of a sudden, there's a red tick on the brand new stocks, and they say, whoa, maybe I gotta sell. So I think there's a lot of that going on in terms of market mechanics. I can't say that with certainty, but given the record inflows, given all of this, continued talk about retail speculation, the recent hearing, and how that had, GameStop had an impact on the market just a few weeks ago, I think this is a mechanics event. The sell-off we'd kind of seen, that wasn't much of a big sell-off, that had a possibly bottomed yesterday. It's possible. So I'm remaining long. As the chairman of Interactive Brokers has said, if they are printing money, the market must go up. And I believe that. I'm on that train all the way. That said, I'm not going to be surprised by any sort of pullback. And if we continue to rise very highly, I'm going to prepare for some sort of mild pullback. I think all the pullbacks are going to be mild. People always talking about wanting to raise the roof. I think what we've been doing and the forces have been leading to is raising the floor, kind of putting a bottom under the market. Things like printing of money will do that. Inflation will do that. Stimulus will do that. But most importantly, we've seen companies expand earnings and increase margins. And that's something that's going to continue with them for a very long time. Not to say those other forces aren't, but those are fundamental forces that improve the business in real terms, not just in nominal terms. We have these nominal forces, which I don't really care about. Maybe at some point we'll be buying stocks in Bitcoin. Who knows? But we'll see what happens. So seems to me that right now, things are looking okay. I'm not crazy about a whole lot. There are some stocks that I think are super well priced, particularly in the real estate section of the market. I don't know why it's being so neglected, you know, just is. I expect us to do well once the market begins to open up, the, you know, super speculative stocks begin to cool off, and people look to better investments that cash flow in some way, which real estate is, in my opinion. And something like Regeneron, you know, Kathy Wood mentioned this the other day. I've been long Regeneron, got, as soon as she mentioned it, I got even longer and more bullish on that one stock. This is a stock I've had for months now. And that's a stock I would buy. Not because I'm saying it, because they've got CRISPR exposure, which, you know, if you can edit genes, you can cure all genetic disease. That is a large market. And I like the position. So we'll see what happens. Have a good weekend. And until next time, peace out.